Hello, everyone. My name is Artem. I'm a program manager on Azure AD B2C team. And in this video, we'll talk about Azure AD B2C user migration strategies and approaches you can consider. Let's get started. The user directory in Azure AD B2C is essentially a flat table of users and identity data about the users. These attributes are common pieces of identity information that you may wish to know about a user. It is important to define the right set of user attributes to store in Azure AD B2C directory. Azure AD B2C has several most common user identifying attributes available for you to choose from. These attributes are called built-in attributes. Built-in attributes are stored within the user directory and cannot be deleted or modified, though you can choose not to use them. Additionally, you can create up to 100 attributes that are specific to applications your customers will interact with. While planning to migrate authentication to Azure AD B2C, you need to decide what attributes you wish to store as part of the user's profile in Azure AD B2C directory and what attributes you wish to keep within the application itself. It is a good idea to store a few well-chosen attributes related to user's identity instead of using Azure AD B2C as a substitute for a customer relationship management system. This ensures your authentication tokens are easy to manage and more complex user profile attributes can be stored in a CRM that supports richer querying and is more purpose-built database system. In general, login information and data about the identity of the user should be stored within the Azure AD B2C user object. Most other data that isn't identity-related should be stored in the application. You should not store sensitive information such as credit card, social security numbers, medical records, or other data regulated by industries' compliance bodies. Also, don't store marketing or communication preferences, user behaviors, and insights. These data should be part of the CRM database. You can call REST API to get this information dynamically during the sign-in. As part of the migration of your existing user base, you can take this time to clean up accounts and data that may no longer be worthwhile to keep. You may find that your user identities have been duplicated many times. Matching on email addresses, cell phone numbers, or other relevant identifiers in your database can help you duplicate user accounts. While you may not be able to arbitrarily remove a potential duplicate account, you can add a flag to the user entry and design a workflow that asks the user to merge a potential duplicate account next time they access your service. Ensure that accounts with junk email addresses, login identifiers, and data are removed in the pre-processing step. Consider to use one of the third-party email list cleaning services that can quickly flag junk accounts that you have in the system. If your existing identity provider has timestamps corresponding to the last time a user accessed your services, you might consider either leaving some accounts behind entirely or flagging them for future deletion as you migrate. If the accounts that you want to migrate from an existing user store have low password complexity, then the strong password strengths enforced by Azure AD B2C, you can disable the strong password requirement. You may also ask the user to reset the password on the first sign-in. Migrating from existing identity provider to Azure AD B2C might also require migrating existing user accounts. Two migration methods are discussed in this video, bulk import and seamless migration, or so-called just-in-time migration. Bulk import process involves reading user profiles from existing identity provider and creating new accounts in Azure AD B2C directory using Microsoft Graph API. Use bulk import when you have access to user plain text credentials, such as username and password, or when credentials are encrypted, but you can decrypt them and import to Azure AD B2C directory. You can also import users with generated passwords and force them to change the password using Azure AD B2C password reset policy. If that is not acceptable, you can use seamless migration. In seamless migration, you use a custom policy to query REST API, which you create, to set each user's password at first sign-in. Use seamless migration flow in case plain text credentials in the existing identity provider are not accessible. With bulk import, you are required to write an application or script that use the Microsoft Graph API to create user accounts in Azure AD B2C. Your migration application reads the user accounts from the existing identity provider, including their current credentials such as username and password, and create corresponding accounts in Azure AD B2C directory with the current credentials. Once accounts are created and provisioned in the core store, users can use their username and password to sign in. An Azure AD B2C policy engine could validate them, making RPC code authentication services. You can also import users with generated passwords and force them to change the password using Azure AD B2C password reset policy. In a similar way, your migration application read the user accounts from the existing identity provider, generating passwords this time, and create corresponding accounts in Azure AD B2C directory. Users are redirected then to password reset policy. Policy engine validate local account present using such identifiers email and leverage self-service password reset service to send OTP code. Once OTP code is validated, users can enter the new password. Policy engine will store the new password in the core store using Graph API. Once password is configured, users can sign in with their local account as usual. While using bulk import, you might consider to create test accounts so you can check the sign-in flow, run the import incrementally, check the data for missing accounts and attributes, consider Microsoft Graph throttling error message handling, and test the migration process using created test accounts. Seamless migration flow might still require bulk migration for user accounts to clean existing user data identifier during the planning phase. Once bulk migration is complete, use a custom policy for user sign-in to read Azure AD B2C account and check whether the account is flagged for migration. If so, call the REST API, which you create, to validate username and password in the existing identity provider. Write the password to Azure AD B2C account if credentials are correct, and send the migration status using custom attributes to indicate that user account was migrated successfully. Once password is configured, users can sign in with their local account as usual without calling a REST API. In this video, we learned about such user migration strategies as bulk import and seamless migration. We also looked at preparation steps you might consider during the planning phase. You can find more information in the links below. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you.